Who knows what a poopa is?
The 8th annual Friedrich's Ataxia Scientific Symposium was well attended by FA community members, researchers, and pharmaceutical partners, all vested in finding a cure.
So Friedrich's Ataxia is a rare genetic condition. It occurs in about 1 in 50,000 young adults.
Dr. Zesowitz opened the symposium with updates from the clinical trial studies taking place at the USF Ataxia Research Center.
When we looked at the long-term data, it appears that patients who are on high-dose Epi-743 had less disease progression than what would be considered or expected in a natural history study.
What is maybe one or two things that you guys have learned from a clinical trial?
FA patients hosted four panels of researchers, giving them the chance to moderate questions.
Can I take a selfie?
It's fun and helpful to come to events like this so I can get other people's perspectives and actually talk through any questions that come up because maybe I don't understand a word or don't know the medical scientific terms they tend to lean towards.
What is a significant breakthrough?
It's really exciting to come and share my story and my perspective on how I've been involved in different research studies. It's something that a lot of people should know, especially researchers, about how patients actually feel about trials and studies.
The burning question is, when in your mind, kind of how far out do we have a treatment?
Understanding what we struggle with day to day, what our lives look like, and I didn't realize there was not a disconnect, but sometimes there can be a little discord between what they're working on and they think would be beneficial and really what the main needs for the patient population are.
Dr. David Lynch, who's been working on FA research for the past 20 years, says the exchange between patient and researcher is important.
Well, the patients, particularly the Friedreich ataxia patients, bring in a motivation, a reason for doing all these things that we do. They are a very normal group of people who just happen to have a motor disorder. They're my friends, and that's the way we treat each other.
For USF Health News, I'm Sandra C.